incredible this opening has been and how amazing your duet was. So much fun, so powerful. Tell me, where did you get your inspiration for this particular piece?
Well, for the samba, the music is so, Jean Paul has so much vibe into it. And I was trying to give JJ this kind of like, it's like dancing food, right?
Yes.
You want him to be able to take it, swallow it, feel it, digest it, and throw a great choreography. And but with Jensen, it was so easy because the girls step right in. Oh yeah, she's in it to win it. and so is JJ. And you look at their body, it's so powerful. My job was to tame them down a little bit, you know. And for Cole and Annalie, it was a pasodoble from a different nature because the music is so epic.
Yeah.
So I needed to create some moment of stillness to let the music catapult them even higher. Mm-hmm. And Cole is like such a powerful dancer. And Annalie analyzed it a little bit, and all of a sudden she emerged like a bullet out of a gun.
Yeah, she lived through that, which was really wonderful to see.
Yeah.
So as a choreographer, and then seeing these dancers from season to season, where do you draw your inspiration from? What are some things like books or life and stories?
You know, I know it's going to sound a little easy as an answer, but every single season bring different cast, different dancers. I get my inspiration from the dancers. I did the academy this year, so I knew them, and somehow I know the level needs to be high. And let's face it, it's season 15. So you have to push those routine at the level of the amount of year this show being aired. And
yes,
so if you go anywhere lower, people is going to tune off and they're going to go somewhere else.
And so how is that for you expanding?
No. For me, it's a long process because you have to clear the music, production need to like the music, and then you go into those vision, and obviously, you don't know who you're going to teach like about 12 hours to 24 hours before.
Right.
So you can't really adjust. So they have to step up and meet my expectation.
Yes. And you are constantly going. You are always so busy and you are so wonderful in your energy and your light that you bring to this show. What is something that you do as a choreographer, as a creative, as an artist that helps you stay centered? Something that brings you back to where you need to be in order to create, in order to give, in order to be in your own?
You know, I got a beautiful family back home. I got a little daughter with disability and she's 19. She's our big doll, our princess. So it grounds me so much just thinking about them, be with them. And my wife is just unbelievable. I can do what I do because she does what she does. And I dedicate those two choreography to them. And hopefully they're proud of me.
And let me just say there's something to be said about gratitude. Gratitude for life and gratitude for everything that's brought you here. Thank you so much for talking with us. Is there any other tips you can give those dancers out there, aspiring creatives and artists, to continue to push through, stay authentically to themselves? Are there any tips or inspiration?
Yeah, you know, authenticity is the basic. Be yourself, be true to yourself, listen to masters, listen to the people who could bring you to the next level. Don't hesitate to be humble, and because if you're humble, you will learn. If you think you know better, and you think you're center of the universe, you might not gonna go that far. But I mean, talent is a gift, and it needs to be worked at. And if you leave that gift in the corner and you try to take the dust off and say, "Oh yeah, I'm gonna do that," no. Every day, humble, be true to yourself, and learn from the best.
I mean, can it be any more inspiring than that?